John?
Marshal?
Gentlemen! It's time. We must go.
Why? What's happening?
Seth has managed to get himself inside. But we can't leave it too long, or they will soon realize how very curious he is and remove him from the premises. Or slit his throat and watch him bleed to death. But for a minute, he will delight and amuse them. That's when he'll get us inside.
Okay.
Marshals of the law, when the shooting starts, take that as your cue to start awarding each other medals.
Huh?
I mean, take that as a cue to get inside and clean up the mess.
Oh.
All I care about is Williamson. It is vital we stop him.
Agreed. That man is a stone-cold killer.
Williamson's a proud fool. The question is which will win out between his pride and his instinct for survival.
Ensconce yourself in the back of my wagon, John, so that we can make our grand entrance.
Come on, let's go.
All right, good. Now just stay put till I tell you otherwise. That scoundrel Seth had better not let us down. Once we're inside and I've lulled our adversaries into a false sense of security with some beguiling sales patter, I will give you the signal.
What signal?
The moment you hear a sharp rap on the side of the wagon, rise like the phoenix and start shooting like you've never shot before. This is it, my dear boy. The moment of truth. Me and you, John. One last time into the breach. This is going to have to be the performance of my life. I hope my nerves don't get the better of me. I'll be honest with you, John, I'm a little jittery. John? John?
It reeks of miracles back here.
Thank God. Now I'll be ready with that machine gun, my dear boy. I'll be a sitting duck in there. My good men, what would you say if I said immortality was at hand? What would you say if I told you I could teach you to fly? What would you say if I told you I could turn a man into a beautiful woman? Impossible, yes, once, but no more. Gentlemen, I bring you wisdom from the East. I have here in this wagon some of the finest goods, the best medicines, and the newest inventions available for you and your families. Exotic trinkets from the far reaches of the earth, elixirs that give vigor and strength. And for you men of physical skill and athletic physique, this miraculous elixir can keep the muscles supple and relax the cords. It loosens the joints and gives a feeling of vigor and freshness to the whole system. Why, some men have reported to me that after drinking it for 1 month, they can chew through steel.
What the hell?
It's a trap!
You
got
should
give them the message!
Get them down!
I just bad spot here!
This was a mistake! Great! Stop!
No!
I'm never making it out of here! This is a nightmare! Hurry, John!
Thank you.
like a dang pig. Them cocksucking sumbitches escaped the other side of the fort.
All right, let's go.
Let's find those bastards.
I think my work here is done. Godspeed, gentlemen. I bid you farewell.
I'm gonna kill you dead.
Let's go, boys. Hellfire.
That's the last of them. We still can't find Williamson anywhere.
Hey, it's the snake oil guy!
Gentlemen, let me in, for goodness sake!
That fool must be hiding.
Men, it is time to start tearing this place apart and find out where he's cowering!
You got a sense of urgency here, please?
Open the gate! It's the snake oil guy!
Get the goddamn gate open and lock it behind him!
Oh, we've got company, gentlemen. These scoundrels have got reinforcements riding this way.
Oh, my good Lord above. There must be 100 of them.
This should do the trick.
Don't let them get too close. Come on.
Mr. Marston, we got a live one. He says, Bill's already run off to Mexico yesterday morning.
You'll never get him.
Javier Escuela. He's gone to see Javier Escuela. That should make things interesting. Where in Mexico?
How
should I know?
Oh! Where in Mexico, you little shit?
Someplace near Chuparosa, I think he said. That's bandit country.
Chupa feckin' Rosa! Oh, I'll take you there, John. I'm real popular down there. You just meet me at the ferry. I've got lots of friends down south.
I'll see you at the ferry, Irish.
I'll just get me things.
I'm sorry about this, John. I guess you'll be heading to Mexico.
So it would seem. How is it down there?
Wonderful. A sweet, peace-loving people with the love of social justice. May you always find coin in your pocket. It's been a pleasure spending time with you, boy.
You too, Mr. West Dickens. Marshal?
All right, boys. That's enough.
what happened to these folks.
Yes, well, that's what makes you such an interesting fellow, Mr. Irish. Ah, Mr. Marston, I've come to wish you well. How are you, sir?
I'm okay.
It seems that our friend Mr. Irish here is well connected south of the border.
Oh, it's true. They love me down there. It's like a second home. I've got more friends than you could shake a stick at, should you so desire.
So you know the way?
Oh, it's easy. We just get on me raft here and let the current sweep us away to paradise. Come on then, Dobby.
I'm not sure your idea of paradise and mine are quite the same, Irish.
Relax. We'll have a great time and we'll find your man, Williamson. No bother.
I hope so.
Hey, come on now. Look at it this way. I know we ain't exactly old pals, but, you know, have I ever done you wrong?
No, but not through lack of trying.
Hey.
Well, you boys have fun down there. I shall miss you, John Marston.
Thank you. Where are you headed?
Oh, me? Oh, London or Paris or maybe Peking. I'm a traveling man, sir. This land is much too small for the likes of me.
Well, try not to get yourself killed.
Oh, well, yes, we men of science are not a very loved bunch in this land of myth and superstition. I'm off to the civilized world where men like myself are revered and given medals.
Ha!
Have fun.
The same to you, sir. The same to you.
Nice of you to turn up for once, Irish.
What do you mean?
In usual fashion, you conveniently missed all the action at Fort Mercer.
What can I say? I woke up with me head in a pair of tits, and it felt ill-mannered not to get reacquainted with him.
At least you got your priorities straight.
You know me, Johnny boy. I'll be late to me own funeral. They say God invented whiskey to stop the Irish from ruling the world.
Well, you're here now.
I can't swim, you know.
Me neither. But a current like this will carry you for miles. We'll end up on shore sooner or later.
Look out, bandits!
There's too many of them. Cut the rope. We'll drift down river.
Oh, my good lord.
You're making a big mistake,
oh,
friend!
Man. Guess I got up to more mischief than I remember on my last visit to Mexico. Just wipe the river out. No point trying to land till we're well away from these bastards.
I give up now if I would.
There's some ammunition near the back of the raft. Grab it if you're running low. For the love of God! And I can go back.
How long? I've seen tougher cows hurt!
They're all along the bank. Over there! Come on, we're all friends here!
You ain't gonna win this!
Nobody shoots at Irish in legs.
What the hell did you do to these fellas?
I've
Parker thought it was something to do with money. And thought there was some misunderstanding about a fellow driver, but the demon has escaped.
Get the hell away from me!
Exactly the reception I was expecting.
They're not ones to forgive and forget, these fellas.
It's too late to talk about things! What the hell did you do to these fellas?
I thought it was something to do with it. And possibly some misunderstanding about a fella's daughter, but the details escaped. Kill these ungrateful bastards!
This is the fourth time your so-called friends have nearly got me killed. I thought you said they loved you over here.
They do. At least the lassies do. Oh, their big brown eyes turn stone into butter, they would. Now, the Mexicans know how to make a bottle of liquor, too. What, that pulque? Now, there's a drink as would take the frost out of a frosty morning. Oh, you're gonna have some fun.
I'm just here for Bill Williams.
Well, I'm glad to be back. This place is a wild devil's paradise.
Apart from the fellas trying to kill you.
Down here, they call me El Rato, the cat, on account of me stealth and cunning.
I'm pretty sure Rato means rat, my friend. I like it, though. A little more inventive than Irish.
Well, you Americans never were very creative with your use of language, was you, John Marston? Shite! There's more fools behind that rock! Nobody should get out of the way!
Who's that? Do you want to die?
Bloody Nara!
I haven't stepped foot in this country, and they're already trying to kill me.
Well, you can insist on fraternizing with a notorious Irish outlaw. There's the idiot!
Don't you
hear me? Come on, my bastard! Miss Marston! Look there, on top of the cliff.
Just drop the gun! It ain't worth it! So much for your damn connections, Irish.
I told you they knew me in Mexico, didn't I? Escapades, Johnny boy, I really will.
I doubt you'll remember any of it, Irish.
There's a beach coming up on the left. Hang on, we'll be on dry land soon.
Getting out of that boat in death.
These horses look fresher and healthy.
Before you degrade these poor fools any further, tell me where I'm headed.
Of course, of course. Let me think.
You do know people down here, aside from your friends who welcomed us on the way.
Yes, I think so. I was real drunk last time I was here, John. You know how it is. I met an American guy, saw him shoot a man, drank with him in the village of Chuparosa. Funny guy! Or was that Canada? No, that was Canada. Guy here, not funny, but he's real nice. Failing that, you could try the provincial governor, Colonel something or other. Some Spanish name. He's based out of Escalera. I played three-card stud with him. Was it four-card Monty? I forget. He was a real nice chap. Maybe he was a real bastard. I was real drunk last time, John.
Well, thanks a lot for your help. Oh, let me guess. You gotta be on your way.
The famed hospitality isn't what it once was, and I've never been known to overstay me welcome. So off I go to greener pastures. Good luck, John. You're an angry and a back-ugly man, but not a bad one.
Let's go!
Just a love sign. interrumpas, pendejo, la dejé en la casa. Y les digo, de aquí para acá, chingan a su madre. Y que no, cállese, güey. Y de aquí para acá, son pendejos.
¡Eh, hey, gringo! ¿Hablas español?
No, sir. Pardon, pero yo hablo un solo poquito español.
Poquito.
¿Habla inglés?
Oh, sí, gringo. Hablo mucho inglés.
Sí.
Hablo filthy fucking bean eater. Hablo slippery little Mexican. Oh. Hablo little piece of cheese. ¿Comprende, amigo? ¿Comprende? Hey, what are you doing here, gringo? I don't remember inviting you to my country.
I don't think you did, amigo. I mean you no harm.
You mean us no harm? This is funny. What harm could you do to us exactly?
Nothing, amigo. Now, I appreciate the welcome committee, but I'd hate to spoil a beautiful afternoon on such beautiful land with any further unpleasantries. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Hold it, gringo. I think you're forgetting something. A little taxation. I have a large family.
Very big.
I, too, have a family, friend. So that we may see our families again, I suggest we part ways amicably.
Can I see the boots, gringo?
I think you can see him from where you're standing just fine, senor.
Take off the boots, Americano.
As you wish.
Oh, very good. Very good indeed, sir. What a great way to improve border relations. An illiterate farmer crossing the river, coming into their civilization and butchering the local peasants. Thank you very much, sir.
Don't mention it, old man.
You kill peasants, you become a peasant.
I never aspired to be anything more.
A socialist, huh? No wonder you left America.
Not many things. Most of them bad. But a man of political principles? No.
Well, then I fear Mexico may not be for you, sir.
Don't you worry about me.
Oh, but I do worry. An angry man a long way from home, a man who handles a gun as sloppy as you.
I can handle a gun okay, partner.
Yeah, as long as you're killing quail or peasants. But if you have to face another man, you don't stand a chance.
And you do?
I can show you a few tricks. Come with me.
Hold on. What's your name?
That doesn't matter anymore. And you?
I never had a name, mister. I was raised in an orphanage.
A real American, huh? Wonderful. Just wonderful. Well, you won't make it in the circus, but you can shoot. Keep on practicing.
Thank you, old man.
Now, who are you?
No one interesting. Who are you?
Landon Ricketts. Not a name that means much anymore.
It means a little. You were famous when I was a boy.
Yeah, killing men's a strange kind of fame. I was the fastest in my time. I must have been. I'm the only one left.
What are you doing here?
Living quietly. Waiting.
For what?
I don't know. And you?
I'm looking for a couple of men. Bill Williamson, Javier Escuela. Escuela's from here.
It could be. This whole place is teeming with a... with Americans on the run, Mercenaries, locals hell-bent on revolution.
Revolution? Another one?
Yeah. Never really is. This whole place has been a hotbed for revolution since before the Spanish left. Now there's another local guy running around promising the peasants their freedom. Ah, just like the last two or three. Local government? Foul bunch. Colonel Allende, he runs this place like a feudal king. He's an awful individual.
Is that so?
Yeah. Until someone puts a bullet in his head. Come on, let's get back to it. You gotta keep that back straight. Otherwise, it makes the gun jump. See if this Schofield makes a difference. Now that's a real gun.
Carajo, gringo! No te da pena!
Well done. Now that wasn't so hard, was it? Come on, I've got another idea. The birds around here are always raising hell, scavenging and scaring the life out of the locals. I say we put your newfound skills to the test while doing a public service for the good people of Chuparosa. Here will do. I'm gonna scare up some birds. Let's see if you can take down more than one at a time. Nicely done, sir. You've been taught well. I'd have to say I'm surprised you heard of Landon Ricketts. I would have thought an old goat like me would have been long forgotten by now.
I heard many a story when I was a boy. Still do, sometimes.
What, these days? I find that hard to believe. What do people say?
Oh, you know how them conversations go. Fellers arguing over who's the toughest, who's the fastest, and who shot people in the back.
I place good money on me still being the fastest.
Is that so, old man?
Ay, Señor Ricketts! Señor Ricketts! Señor Ricketts! Señor Ricketts! Por favor, señor. Our back wagon's under attack just outside of town. We need your help again.
Whoa, slow down, Ramon. We'll take care of it.
Thank you, señor. Again, you are the savior of this town.
Well, my friend, are you ready to take a less theoretical exam?
Sure. I don't think I ever rode with no savior before.
Let's haul out. Time we put you to work on some bigger prey. Yeah!
Come!
So why are you looking for these two men?
It's a long story. We used to ride together. We was all friends once.
Only a buzzard feeds on his friends. There must be a high bounty on their heads.
What would you do if somebody took the people you love and told you they'd die if you didn't do as they asked?
I'd show them what a big mistake they'd made. There they are. Follow me.
I'll kill you!
That's it. I'll wipe that smile off your face.
Gracias a Dios. Me salvaron la vida.
All right, let's move out. Everybody, stay alert.
I can see you haven't lost your touch, Landon.
Nobody said I had. You talk real big for a boy who couldn't shoot straight a half hour ago.
And you talk big for an old man who can't stand up straight no more.
You're a long way from being a Landon Ricketts partner, young, old, or otherwise. Go on, just like I taught you. Now let's get this wagon back where it belongs.
So much for this quiet life of yours, Mr. Ricketts.
I didn't say I'd become a coward. I'm not gonna stand by and watch good people suffer.
They've been beaten down for too long. I give them some hope.
They don't know how lucky they are.
Damn right they don't, my sarcastic little apprentice.
Sano y salvo. Nunca podré agradecer lo suficiente.
Buy me a whiskey later, and we'll call things about even.